Was that a fun bath? Was a fun bath. Want to have another one? But it was fun, right?
Going to do the face first. I believe this is the second smallest one I have. It's the 3 millimeter. I don't like the right clean closed face. I just like to get so that she's looks lovely. Helps if you can be a little ambidextrous. Clean face, eh? Nice clean face. Don't lick. Don't lick. Be able to see her eyes. I hope some of you aren't cringing. Your groomers might have some problems with how I'm doing this. This has worked really good for me and haven't done anything that's hurt her so far, so I'm doing it for just 2.5 years. My first poodle. I guess we can do feet. Now I do take it off for the feet. Now this is where I get nice and close. I give what I call monkey feet. Her feet don't have that much hair on them because I did them probably 2 weeks ago. get this one in there too. Being a home groomer is really, you know what? Your dog doesn't really care what they look like so long as they're comfortable. And this little dog is very hot, so even in Canadian winters, she doesn't mind being groomed. I wouldn't say real close in the winter, but the feet are fine to groom in the winter. She doesn't really get cold. She actually sits by the drafty door quite a lot because she's such a little hot dog. Okay, now this cut that I do is called the Pants and Vet Stand, honey. Stand. Pants and vest, and you can sort of see like it's already cut in somewhat. Right now I'm just going to get this really nice and close. And so it's a lot more defined. And it's tick season, so the more of her that I can have short, the better. She likes short. And I think I better offer a little treat because he's been going really good so far. And so this nice short one just really does a great job. Nice if you have a guide to follow. Say I've done this cut before, so it's kind of marked in. And I like this cut because she still has pretty, she still looks like a poodle and kind of fancy. And we're not, definitely not show people. She's a running dog and that's her main job besides being a very nice little friend. Nope, you need to stand up. Don't take the set down, babe. I always think I should have a ponytail holder. So, I like to just kind of go with whatever she wants to do. And sometimes if it takes a couple sessions, I don't either. Are we done that? She's so lovely. Yeah. She's not all that keen on doing this because I have spent a lot of time brushing her today. I like to brush her before I bath her and of course after I bath her. So I bath her and then towel dry her, then let her run around and dry for a while and then I brush her out again. I don't like the dryer and she doesn't like the dryer, so. Okay, I'm gonna do her poop because she feels like sitting right now and I kind of just like to do what she feels like doing because I know this is sometimes not the funnest thing in the world. So, I'm gonna brush this poop up. I've let it grow pretty long. And so I think I'm gonna take it down a fair amount because it just, it doesn't stay up. I don't know what that looks like. They're curved. And so, this usually takes a lot of time. First, I wanna see her eyes. So let's just see those eyes. Good. I didn't get your eyes yet. I know you're not really supposed to do their eyelashes, but otherwise she can't see. So actually if I don't hold her face, she's usually quite still. So now I'm just gonna go along here. Isn't that pretty? It's ombre color. She's really light in the front. She was chocolate brown when she was born. So I'm just going to go around and try and kind of take big sniffy snack. This is being a really good girl. Aren't ya? Yeah. These are little Charlie bites. Hey, she likes those. We bought them because her name was on them. That's even spelt the same way. And she likes them. I think they're liver. And her name is Charlie, so. So this, I just pretend like I know what I'm doing. And just try not to go too crazy. And actually one thing I do that seems to work pretty good as well. Okay, sit up now. Let me see. Pretty good. Not bad at all. Don't move, honey. Okay, so yeah, it's a little awkward on here. Just be still. Find sometimes she'd rather me not touch her and she'll still be still. I think I would get sick of somebody holding on to my nose for very long. Oh, we got a helmet head. Okay, we got a helmet head going on. We'll fix it. We'll fix it here. Okay, so now when you got a helmet head going on, I kind of like the height, but the sides look like a helmet. So round ones. Chin up. There, see, now we can see your pretty eyes, but now we have to see. Okay, you know, that's close. That'll be something I'll probably just go back into and do a few little touch-ups, because there'll be some pieces that aren't exactly perfect. Keep my scissors and stuff on the table so that if I've missed a spot and I notice it later on, then I just walk it off. Her head's pretty, pretty, and oh, it's so soft.
It's so soft.
What a good girl you are. So I don't do anything with the ears. Make sure they're clean and no yucky you know, a bunch of hair in there. I did cut her ears one time. I chopped them straight off here at the bottom, and she looked really goofy, so I'm never going to do that again. Stand. Okay, so now this part, because I've done this part short, you just want this to sort of blend a little bit. And you can use scissors to just round it. I wonder if that would happen. Almost need a spray because I've got the hair climbing up here. It's like magic hairs flying off her. So this cut makes her look muscly. And she is a muscly dog. She's a very athletic girl. As poodles are. They're quite the athletes. I'll just do her shoulder. No, no, stand up, stand up, stand. Thank you. Okay. Just brush this out a little bit. When I first did this, it took me a while to get this shoulder and pant in the right spot. And I don't do anything with the tail anymore because I also cut that too short, and now I don't want that to happen again. So now I'm going to get my really short thing out and do sandy area. Oh, I'm glad that didn't land on my toes. And here she's got a poop in her butt, and that happens. Guard back on. I don't like not having a guard on except for feet. I just don't ever want to get too close. There, that's good. Now, finish up the tummy area, and you have to kind of stretch the skin. You know, like stretch it so that you've got it. You can get it nice and close. And under the armpits is where they can really get some bad knots and tangles. So sometimes I just hold those tangles out and get them off that way. And I love this bravura because you can take this, I don't know if you're supposed to or not, but you can take the guards off on the fly. You know, take them off, use it. Oopsie, sorry. I need to do kind of a V, but I don't really care about that too much. I'm only doing this because people always ask me how I do it, and I enjoy doing it, and I think it's fun, so if you want to do it, why not? It's not like, unless your dog is a show dog and you want it to be fancy as all get out, then really, I wouldn't have got a poodle if I didn't want to groom it. Okay, now we got you to turn around. Doing great. So now I'm just going to go along the back and do the same thing as I did on that side to the short area. going around the vest. Again, this is the number 3 millimeter guard. So it's, oops, it's close. I actually did this about a month ago, or maybe even longer than that. And because I thought we were going to have spring, but then it turned to minus 20. So I had to find her a scarf because it was minus 20 and she had, it was like she was bare naked. So I jumped the gun a little bit there. Again, stretching the skin so you can get it close so it's nice and even. Area on the inside of the legs. Again, this is a sandy area. Looks like we've been a little bit lax in doing that spot. I hear about lots of people whose dogs pee on their legs. I'm glad. I guess it might just be more of a boy thing, but she actually pees like a boy quite often. Nope, stay where you are. I got my guard on. They get so velvety. I love that velvety feel of a poodle. And your tummy's so nice and soft. Oh, she's soft. And this Grooming holds its battery for a really long time. And also, if it's running out and you still aren't done, you can plug it in while you're using it. Sometimes you find with poodles, when once you give them a haircut, their collar is too small or too big. This is the best brush ever. It's called a Chris Christensen brush. And although I said I would never spend $100 on a whole lot of things, but a dog brush was at the top of that list. But turns out it is worth it. There, that's good. Just move this off a little bit. For her nice defined butt and shoulders, makes her look all muscly. Now I'm going to put the 12 millimeter back on to do the neck and blend that into the head. Otherwise, she looks like kind of, you know what, you're facing the wrong way here. Let's do your neck. That's a girl. And she's lovely. Let's, okay, chin up. Good girl. And this is still part of the vest, I guess. So I do like to get it. You can see the definition here and here, maybe. I'm not sure if you can or not. Again, I always think I should bring a ponytail over and then I always forget. Okay, I'm good now. Now I get the treat. So that's how that works. Testy. There, that's a good girl. Yeah, what else? Are we done? Should we clean up those eyes a little bit? Hey, should we clean up those eyes a wee bit? Let's, I don't know. I think you're almost done. I think you look pretty good, miss. So, there she is. I like to keep this full. It looks pretty. Oh, you know what? I don't know if I did these. I didn't. Or did I? Who knows? You know what? I'm going to use this. She's standing up really nice. I love how that sometimes just go right up like that. Give you that nice scissored edge, which I am not good at. And again, that is super dangerous, so if you, it's not that big of a deal. Move your head. There. Let's go up the legs a little bit. And that perspective. The things I use is the Chris Christensen coral brush. And what makes it different is the length of the bristles. And I don't know what else it is, but I don't think you can have a poodle and not have one of these. And clippers. And they are the best I've had.